In this video, we're taking a look at how to use the TI calculator to calculate the mean and standard deviation of a probability distribution. And this will be for the old operating system. For the new operating system, the instructions are just a little bit different. But this should at least get you started. You can take a look at the calculator packet for the new operating system instruction. But here's the probability distribution we're going to be dealing with. We've got all of our possible outcomes listed here, 0 through 5. We've got the probabilities associated with each possible outcome. And then here's how this would look in your calculator. First, you need to take the outcomes that are possible and put them into one of your lists. And then you need to take the probabilities that are attached to each outcome and put those into another list. So here I'm going to go into Stat and Edit. And I'm going to put all of these values, the values of the random variable, I'm going to put those into list 1, and I'm going to put the associated probabilities into list 2. It is vitally important when you put these into your lists that you have them lined up. So the probability that's associated with the outcome of 0 needs to be right next to it in the lists. And same thing with the outcome of 1, the probability associated with that needs to be right in the next list over. They need to be able to match up. So your best bet is just to put them in the exact order that they appear. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 there. And then 0.27, 0.02, 0.13, 0.08, 0.44, and 0.06 in the second list. Okay, so we have that there. And then I'm going to quit back to the main screen. So second mode to quit to my main screen. Then we're actually just going to run one variable stats. So we'll go to Stat, over 1 to the Calculate submenu. So I'll press the right arrow key to go over 1 to calculate. Select one variable stats by pressing Enter. And then here, rather than just putting an L1, we'll need to put second 1 to get my list 1 to pop up, the list in which your variables are stored. If you had stored these in list 3, for example, you would put L3 here. But basically the list where the possible outcomes are stored, comma, so you press the comma key next, right here next to the parentheses, then second 2 to denote the list in which the probabilities are stored. So list 1, comma, list 2. Again, if you had your probabilities in a different list, if you were doing this in like list 3 and list 5, you would do L3, comma, L5. Okay, but one of our stats, L1, comma, L2, press enter. This thing right here, the X bar, that's your mean of the probability distribution, but your calculator always labels mean as X bar. This actually, however, represents population data, so you'll want to make sure that that gets labeled as mu. So for this set of data, it came out to 2.58 for our X bar. And then your standard deviation down here, you'll notice your calculator's smart enough to recognize that this is population data when it does the standard deviation. It doesn't even give you the sample standard deviation, but it gives you the population and says, oh, that's about 1.77. So our standard deviation for this probability distribution is about 1.77. And that's how you find the mean and standard deviation of probability distributions on the calculator.